Hey, yo. So the update has not been released. They released a new ability for assassins. It's called dagger. It's basically dagger throw, but it's basically switch strike, but better. You know, a lot of assassins complain it has a really bad hitbox. To that I say, screw you. You're just really bad at aiming. Because if you're really good at using switch strike, yeah, dagger throw is actually better. Because instead of switching places, and for example, right, imagine you're in like in Nilgoth, right? Once in the bank and once almost near the barber, right? Not the barber, but the Vincent, the stat reset thingy. So you throw your switch strike, you just switch places, you do damage, but there's not a lot of stuff you can do with it. But if you have dagger throw, you go like you teleport to be behind the enemy. That's a really good combo. In example, you don't use Shadow Flurry because you know it's gonna miss because it takes a long time to wind up. So what you do is you throw your dagger throw and you execute them immediately. So it's like instant death for anyone. Then think about it. It's actually better than Switch Strike. So stop complaining. You just have really bad skill issue for just spamming, you know, your auto clicker and stuff. And they changed the Warder's HP. Mainly Berserk. I mean, Warriors used to have 2.8k, and now they only have. Let me check. And now they only have 2k, 2045 to be exact. And Knight's HP has been just from 2. I think it's 3k or something, to 2k75. It's not. I mean, and then Hunters got massive buff from 1.5k to 1.8k. Ranger from 1.1k to 1.7k, and mages still the same, because I do remember using mage and I still have 1.9k and about 2.3 or 2.1k with 70 vit. Okay, so why do I think this is balanced? First of all, the game is orienting towards PvP for end game because we have Badlands and we have that map for capturing points or flag. I don't remember what that place is called, but it has been announced a lot of time. I just forgot the name. And then they have this new map after the pit. I don't remember what it's called, but yeah, those places are coming. And yeah, back the game's basically orienting towards PvP now, so they have to balance stuff, right? And for those who are complaining that warriors should have more HP, but then okay, so what do you have to back up your claim, you know? Because first of all, you have paladins that can spam stuff and do like thousands of damage in just a mil in just a fraction of a second, like this, and everything just simply die. And you have knights that can infinite stun you, and remind you, just one shield bash from a knight that's not even using gold tier. Like my friend uses a blue gear. I mean blue tier. What's the thing called? The sword, right? For knights from the pit. I forgot what it's called. But yeah, he uses that sword, a blue tier, right? Not upgrade, it's like too ancient. Right? It can already one shot hunters. So I think he does about 1. Wait, how much does he do? I think he does like 2.1k per hit with his shield. So yeah, that's a lot of damage already. Like you can one shot even mages. And even if you don't die, they can simply just spin slash you to death. So in other words, they're already OP. And we have berserkers. Berserkers are basically assassins but better. Yeah, I'm not joking. I mean, you have like immense amount of hit. You have really massive hitbox, the ground slam, and you have the skill to teleport from place to place, which is the that's not basic. I mean, not basic teleport, but you get what I mean. You move so fast that you might as well teleport to places, right? What's that thing called? Your headlong dive, and then you have the ferocious assault that basically kills everything in its path. Like it's really broken, but thank God they fixed the hitbox like last week or something. So yeah, the warriors in general are really broken from the beginning, right? And them having a HP nerf, not even damage. Like HP nerf is actually balanced. You know why is that exactly? First of all, the game is orienting towards, you know, PvP. So, you know, PvE will no longer be relevant. I mean, in PvE, why do you exactly need a lot of HP? You just kill everything so fast, you don't need to take any damage, you know? And then let's say in PvP, right? You have a skill there's tons of damage that can basically destroy Japan like how America's did. And then you can teleport from China to basically the UK or something with a blink of an eye. And you have a lot of HP, like your HP pool is bigger than Russia's terrain, basically. I don't know, I can't make a joke out of that, I'm really sorry, but you get what I mean. You have a lot of HP, very fast movement, very high damage, and what do you get? A very unbalanced class. That's basically what berserkers are right now. Not to mention, they can also buff themselves to do more damage. And they have the gladiator armor, which on top of that, deals more damage. So what I'm trying to say is, they're really OP. So when they fix the HP nerf, it's actually really balanced now. Like you can't basically just go in and be brain dead. You know, like back then you can go into a trap, or I don't know, just Shadow Flurry, tank a Shadow Flurry or something, and still kill the enemy, right? But now you actually think what you want to do, like how you want to fight them, how you're going to engage, what you're going to do. Like what I'm saying is, it now actually takes skill to use berserkers instead of just spam one button and everything just dies. Get it? And then we have knights. I think knights have the most HP nerf out of all, from about 3k to 4k. From about, I think knights used to have like 3k or 4k HP, I might be wrong. Nerf to 1.8, nerf to 2k, specifically 2075 to be exact, like 30 HP difference.
Your tweet is reaching a lot of people.
Tweet over.
No,
huh? Where was I? Alright, so basically knight has a lot of HP, can stun people and do a ton of damage, right? So that alone is not balanced at all, and why I think them nerfing knights are actually balanced, right? For example, you get shield bash, you either die or you get stunned. And mind you again, knights have the 150 dex perk, and they have the mushroom armor, and they have the 100 feet perk. And then you have the shield to increase your damage and take less damage, and to reduce your shield bash cooldown. Knights are really, really OP. Like once you it's either you die from the ground slam, or they just don't die. I mean, like example, right? You can look at your guard down, just spam skill right in front of them, and all you can do is to counter them is just parry. See, even their parry stuns you. So there's like no way for you to escape knights general. So hence why I think that knights getting nerfed is actually a good thing. Like yeah, they do lose their points at being knight, but then again, knights are mostly oriented as a stunning class rather than a tanking class right now. And if that's the option, the path that the Berserker wants to take knights instead to being like a stun oriented class instead of, you know, tanking, then sure, nerf the HP for stuff. But and then if you know they want to make knights tanky, what they could do is, instead of giving them a lot of HP, just increase their base defense or something. So yeah, that's why I think the HP nerf for warriors are really needed. But tell me what you think about it, because I already know in the comments there's gonna be a lot of people complaining because all they do is just spam ground slam to win, and once they can't do it and they actually need to use skills to, you know, fight, they just cry, you know. But anyways, yeah, I'd like to hear comments from below. See you guys later.